Car Must-Haves, Part 2. This tray that attaches to the steering wheel allows you to eat comfortably without having to balance anything on your lap or the console, and is sturdy enough to hold a combo meal. If you flip the tray over, it's perfect to place your laptop on if you need to get some work done in your car. This trash can be clipped around your center console and helps to keep your car from getting dirty. It has a Velcro lid with storage pockets on the side, and it's also waterproof so you can feel comfortable throwing away liquids, and the material on the inside is super easy to clean. And lastly, this emergency escape tool that you will hopefully never have to use, but it's super great to have on hand just in case. One end is a seatbelt cutter and the other end is used to break a window. How we organized our baking supplies in our pantry and went from this to this. I found some really pretty glass canisters with wooden lids, all in different sizes, along with some cute labels, and then I transferred all of our baking supplies into our canisters. And here is the final result. I am loving how organized and uniform it makes everything look. Amazon must-have kitchen gadgets. First up is this mini waffle maker, and it's probably one of my favorite purchases from Amazon. We love making waffles and cinnamon rolls on this, and because of its size, it works a lot quicker and heats up really fast. Next are these silicone garlic peelers, and they come in a set of two, and each tube has small bumps on the inside to help peel the skin off when you roll it back and forth on the counter. And lastly, this twist garlic crusher that looks like Dracula is not only super adorable, but you're able to crush multiple cloves of garlic all at once. Travel must-haves from Amazon. This silicone non-slip mat that's perfect to rest your hot hair tools on to protect your countertops, and it's also a pouch so that you can pack up your hot tools for traveling. This travel makeup case holds a lot. It has tons of compartments for organizing along with pouches for brushes, and the dividers are customizable so you can create different size compartments to fit your products. These packing cubes are amazing. They come with 6 lightweight cubes in different sizes, and they have graphics on the inside to show you what to pack, but you can obviously pack them however you'd like. There are 3 cubes for larger clothing items, 2 smaller cubes for undergarments, and 1 for shoes that even has a pocket for socks. And if your shoes are small enough, you can fit multiple pairs in it. We used these on our 2-week trip to Europe, and they helped us to fit everything in our backpacks.
Amazon Favorites, Episode 60. This is a glow-in-the-dark rocket launcher. That's right. You get 3 little darts that light up, and they fly way up high in the air. You can even aim the rocket launcher so it shoots exactly where you want. Amazon Favorites, Episode 61. This is like Marble Run, but way better. You get 150 pieces of UV light that you shine on the marbles to make them glow in the dark. So many possibilities. It is seriously so much fun. Amazon Favorites, Episode 62. These are toaster bags, the perfect way to make a toasted sandwich in your upright toaster. You can reuse them up to 100 times, and look at this sandwich. They're the best.
Amazon Favorites, Episode 59. These adorable travel scissors are a must for every handbag or car. They are cute, they're compact, and they come in a bunch of fun colors.
Amazon Favorites, Episode 58. You guys tagged me a ton in this, and it's a 20,000 bristle toothbrush. Here are my thoughts.
I think this might be better than my Sonicare. It's awesome.
Things TikTok made me buy, this bear mold. You can add anything to it. I added milk, you can add water, juice, tea, and then put it in the freezer, and it turns into a cute bear ice. This took me a while to open, but it's super cute. I think it would be perfect for a smoothie bowl. If you want to purchase, link is in my bio under Amazon. So I had my friend come over to help me take some photos on my rooftop. We put the camera on a tripod, and this is the scene that we're trying to shoot with the epic background of Times Square. Here's how it turned out. What do you guys think? If you like my photos, follow me on Instagram.